Okay students, now we will move on with the next topic of surface chemistry. I hope you remember what all terms we have discussed in the previous videos. We have discussed about the mechanism of adsorption, then we have discussed types of adsorption, physisorption, chemisorption, then factors affecting adsorption, applications, and one very important graph, Frenlich adsorption isotherm. So today we are talking about catalysis. Now first we will talk about what is catalyst. Catalyst is any substance which alters the rate of the reaction. It may increase or may decrease. And normally it is said it does not take part in the reaction. Even if it is taking part, it will be only physically taking part, but chemically nothing happens to the catalyst. So the definition is written here, the substance which alters the rate of the chemical reaction without itself undergoing chemical change. Now based upon the phenomena by which the catalyst is functioning is called as catalysis. Okay, now based upon whether the catalyst is increasing the rate or decreasing the rate, it is called as a positive catalyst or a negative catalyst. And correspondingly, the mechanism will be called as positive catalysis or negative catalysis. So, positive catalyst increases the rate of reaction. How does it increase the rate of reaction? It lowers the activation energy. In chemical kinetics, we have discussed the activation energy required to for a reaction to complete lowers if we are using a positive catalyst. If we use a negative catalyst, the activation energy increases. So, automatically the rate of reaction also will be lowered. So, these two examples we have taken. Actually, there can be many more, but only one I have written just to explain. Sulfur dioxide plus oxygen. The reaction occurs in the presence of platinum or vanadium pentoxide. It forms SO3. It's a contact process to prepare sulfuric acid. It's one of the reactions taking place there. So, this is increasing the rate of reaction. Increasing, so this is the example of the positive catalyst. It's a positive catalyst. And remember one more thing students, we have discussed that hydrogen peroxide is very unstable. It undergoes decomposition very readily. To lower the rate of decomposition, we have studied that we have to store it in a wax lined bottles. We can also keep phosphoric acid or acetanilide in it and store. So these two will act as a negative catalyst. It will lower the rate of decomposition. It's very difficult to store hydrogen peroxide. Its decomposition is so fast, even if some rough surface is there, some cut surface of the glass is there. That is why we have studied that we store always hydrogen peroxide in wax coated, wax lined bottles. And moreover, if you add this and store, further the rate of decomposition will lower. Okay, so we discuss what is catalyst, the phenomena catalyst is, types of catalyst and phenomena for that. Now these are the functions of the catalyst. Okay, first we have already discussed here, the original form is retained. Physically it may take part, it may allow the surface, it may give the surface, allow the reactants to get attached to it. Products will be formed, it will leave the surface and go, but nothing will happen to it. Chemically nothing will happen. This is the first function of the catalyst, right? Second function, it does not affect the equilibrium. Why? Now what we say here, so if some reactant is there forming product, catalyst increases the rate of forward as well as backward. It increases both the rates equally. It affects both the directions equally. So equilibrium is not affected. It's not only increasing one, because if more reactants are converting to products, correspondingly more products also will form reactants. So it doesn't affect the equilibrium. Only thing is equilibrium will be achieved faster in the presence of the catalyst. Got it? Now next, it's very specific. Catalysts are very specific. You cannot use anything catalyst for any reaction. Like we say in our body also enzymes are there. Enzymes are biochemical catalysts. Any enzyme cannot function for any particular reaction. So they are very specific. They work by lock and key mechanism. We will talk about this in the later part of the chapter. It does, actually these two you can combine. It does not affect the thermodynamic parameters. Internal energy, enthalpy, Gibbs energy, entropy, no thermodynamical parameters are affected. Not that in the presence of the catalyst, entropy change will be there, or you know, more energy will be liberated or less energy will be liberated. Only thing is, it may increase or decrease the rate of reaction depending upon whether we are talking about positive or the negative catalyst. Clear? Now, last two terms we'll talk about, promoters and poison. Like we started, positive and negative catalyst increasing or decreasing. Any substance which increases the activity of the catalyst is called as a promoter. It doesn't affect the reaction. Indirectly, it might be affecting the reaction. But in first go, promoter increases the efficiency of the catalyst. And the poison decreases or inhibits, we can say. It lowers the efficiency. Instead of this, you can inhibit the efficiency. You can also use a term, it lowers the efficiency. Lowers the efficiency of the catalyst. Okay, like we studied this one. This is the example of Haber's process. Haber's process for the preparation of ammonia we use. So in this, iron is a catalyst. Finely divided iron is a catalyst. But molybdenum is a promoter. It increases the efficiency of iron. Okay, likewise here, this example, contact process, the same one which we discussed here, vanadium pentoxide. In this, we will study in P block elements that when SO2 is prepared from sulfur, sulfur is always associated with some impurity of arsenic, which should be removed before it forms SO2 and further it forms SO3, and this SO3 forms sulfuric acid. Why? Because if arsenic is present with sulfur, it will poison this catalyst. It will not allow this reaction to occur. So, this arsenic, which is always associated with sulfur, should be removed before we go ahead with the preparation of sulfuric acid. It's a poison for platinum vanadium pentoxide. Likewise, for Haber's process ammonia. Here we say carbon monoxide is the poison. This should be removed before, you know, we go for preparation of ammonia. It is a poison for this particular reaction, for the preparation of ammonia by Haber's process. Clear, students?